you now. Somebody better get a shout on, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. Somebody praise him. Glory.
In heaven and thou up on earth, therefore let thy words be few.
Are y'all listening? Verse 6.
Suffer not thy mouth to cause thy flesh to sin, neither say thou before the angel that it was an error. Wherefore should God be angry at thy voice and destroy the work of thy hands?
All right, stay right there. Now let me reread the key verses of those verses we read, verse 2 and 6 of the 5th chapter. Verse 2 said, be not rash with your mouth, and let not your heart be hasty to utter anything before God. For God is in heaven, and you up on the earth. Therefore, because I open my mouth. And look at somebody and say, because I open my big mouth. Now, I preached not long ago a message we talking about mouth trouble. You're saying things without thinking what you're saying. And I want to impart unto you some wisdom from God's word that will help you not to suffer so many things. Because in truth and reality, just about, I might as well say all of us are suffering some bad times now and some hard times, not necessarily because of what you did, but because of what you have said. Now, I want you to really understand this, because don't be rash with your mouth. Don't be so quick to speak. And particularly when you are upset and angry, that's the time you ought to tape your mouth up. Because what you say, even during anger, God will not let you go unpunished for what you said. That's what that sixth verse was saying, in case y'all don't understand. Don't say before the angel it was an error. Did y'all read that? Ecclesiastes 5 and 6. Don't say I said that because I was upset. Even if you said it because you was upset, you should have put your hand over your mouth. Look at somebody and say, because I opened my big mouth. Tell them this then. Say, I'm going through with what I'm going through with. Because I opened my big mouth. If you are suffering, going through disappointment, mishap, uncomfortable situation, it has come up on you because of what you have been saying. What you have said. Now, you don't even have to believe what I just said. Honor and keep what you said. But if you turn around with the same mouth and tell that person, I hate you. I can't stand you. Hear this. You make me sick. Guess what? It's one reason you sick. Y'all don't believe the word. Y'all think I'm just talking. The Bible is right. These are not my words. That's why bad things happen to good folks. Because they done said bad things. And you wondering, I'm trying to do right. Yeah, you said it right. You cried. Now, you know you ain't shot nobody. I don't reckon. Somebody said, yes, you did. You assassinated them with your mouth. That's what I'm talking about. What you say kill folk. It assassinate their character. Amen. So the mouth is a dangerous weapon. It is a concealed weapon. You don't know when the folk going to shoot with it. And you don't know who pulled the trigger. But God knows, because when you utter anything before God, it becomes a vow. And I'm going to prove that to you. Maybe. But here's an example. Let's go to Judges chapter 11. I got to skip so that we can save time. Amen. The 11th chapter, I want to read the 30th verse, 31. 34 and 35. Now, you turn over there with me. Now, he said it because how many know you can't say anything without God hearing it? God hear even the very whisper. David said it like this. God is acquainted with, in 139 Psalm, God is acquainted with all what? My ways. My thoughts are known afar off. Do y'all know that what it said? And he said, and lo, there's not a word in my mouth that the Lord does not know it altogether. So in other words, even before you speak it, God already know what you're going to say. And so suddenly, when you say it, his ear is open in every place. Not only his eyes beholding the good and the evil. If his eyes is there, look at somebody and say, ears is too. He not only see you, but he hear you. Ain't no way I can put my eyes there and my ears don't be there because they on my head. Now, go back over it again. Listen to what this said here. And Jepper, how you pronounce that? Somebody?
A vow unto the Lord.
He said something, not did something. He said something to the Lord. What he said?
And said.
Hear what he said.
If thou shalt without fail deliver the children of Ammon into mine hands.
If you, God, do this for me without fail. If you let me win this battle, let me overcome the Amorites, Amos, which is the same. If you let me defeat them, hear what I will do. He's saying it ain't. Look like he ain't really giving too much thought about what he's saying. Listen to what he said.
Then it shall be.
He said, if you give me the victory when I get back home, then this what I'll do.
That whatsoever come forth of the doors of mine house to meet me.
That when I come back with this victory, whoever be the first one come out of my door, out of my house and meet me.
When I return in peace from the children of Ammon.
When I get back in peace from fighting this battle.
Shall surely be the Lord's, and I will offer it up for a burnt offering.
Whatever or whoever come out of my door, out of my house when I come back. From if you give me this victory.
His daughter came out to meet him with timbrels and with dances.
His daughter. His daughter was the first one to come out of his doors, had a tambourine, and was coming out meeting daddy, shouting, oh, God has saved my daddy, brought him back home. God has given him victory. What was his vow? Whoever be first come out my house, I will surely give them back to you, and I will offer them up as a burnt offering unto you. And now his daughter, listen. How many of you have made a right vow unto the Lord? Let's leave this circular thing alone for a moment. How many of you have ever said something like, God, did you just bless me with this? Or with that? I will do thus and thus. God will present you the opportunity to keep your vow. Like today, for instance. I made a vow to the Lord. I said, Lord, if you just do such and such for me, I praise you when nobody else will. Say today. I want to preach. Y'all won't even let me preach. Just to see how they try to push me over there. They want me to tune up for them. I'm sorry, I ain't intend to do that.
What? Said I'm nothing without you.
I'm nothing without you.
In him do I live, move, and have my being.
In him do I live, move, and have my being.
In him do I live, move, and have my being.
In him do I live, move, and have my being.
Said I'm nothing without you.
I'm nothing without you.
Yes, sir. Now, we knew, right?
We knew. That's our ministry.
New ministry.
That's right. Praise God.
Speaking of new, Pastor, I got to talk to you before we have our little service here.
Okay. All right. All right.
But, your wife, I need some privacy. Can I talk to you in private?
Oh, yeah. Man, come on upstairs, huh?
Privacy? This my house and my church. Anything that's in here, I'm going to hear about it. Not to mention, Cam, your business is like I-20 News. Everybody know everything about it.
Is that right?
Hey, yeah. Hold on. Wait a minute now. Then you go judge.
Since you know everything, mm-hmm. and I guess you feel like you know everybody, mm-hmm. did you know your sister Day was coming to our service today?
Yeah, I told her.
Did you know that?
I just told
her.
Can somebody say, rematch?
Babe, you told him?
Yeah, I had to tell him. Now listen, now you know she don't answer none of our calls, so I had to make Kev the middleman.
I had to do it.
What a middleman.
Well,
hello, everyone.
Oh, it's here comes. Miss Day, my sister-in-law. God bless you. All right, all right. Good seeing you.
So what you want?
What I want?
Yeah.
Really?
It's about to get interesting in here. Good service today.
Your husband and Cap said that you was ready to talk. So.
No.
I didn't say it like that, no.
Yeah, we just said you want to come to church. That's all we said. But anyway, since you're here, we glad you're here.
Hey, praise God. Praise God. Thank you.
Ain't you glad, First Lady?
Wait a minute. Church service?
Yeah.
Yeah, the church service. You're about to serve it.
Church.
I can't believe y'all.
What?
You and you tricked me into attending
this
service.
Don't put your hands on my man.
Honey,
stay in your lane. At least I got one. At least he put a ring on it.
Okay,
where yours
at?
Yeah.
I am. And this is supposed to be a first lady.
I am. At least my man steps up to the plate and put a ring on it.
Wait, that ain't my fault. I think
you're
being a little bit judgmental.
Yeah, she always
be. So what if I'm being judgmental? That's my sister, and she know better than this mess. Mama is probably rolling over in her grave with the way you behaving. Mm. Over there laid up with that man, living all in a mess. And I smell liquor on you and the bar. We really gonna start our church service out like this, babe, with the bar perfume?
Well, as I can remember, you used to sneak out of the window and have somebody else come into the house to spend the night. And by the way, you was the first person to give me my first drink.
Wait, what? Whoa.
Hold on, Pastor. As a matter of fact, you was the one that gave me my first shot, too. She the one told me how to turn up.
Whoa, wait a minute. Babe, you ain't never tell me this. You used to drink and smoke?
I'm human.
No, wait a minute now. We got to talk about this here now.
I'm not still in my mess. Babe.
Come on in. Oh, my brother. What's going on, man?
My God.
God bless you.
You know, we got
reservations.
It's time to go. We
got
to go to the New Year's Eve party.
New Year's Eve,
right. You want to be a deacon of the church or something? Who was that? Hey, brother, you come walking in here like you.
Yeah,
Anyway, Pastor, since we got a little time, let me tell you what I had to talk to you about.
Oh, yeah, okay, all right, yeah.
I get on my laptop every now and then.
Yeah, I know.
that have been told. One of the lies our history starts when we were sold. One of the lies taught us every day. When we went to school, black history had no place. One of the lies, how long must this last? I'll tell you the truth.
If you would like to know more about your heritage, please stop by the Cosby Educational Heritage Center in the Ossie Hill Neighborhood Center at 445 Bowman Street. For appointments, please call us at 419-775-8834 or 419-571-4627. And always remember, education is the key.
Yes!
Being with you.